And welcome back. The program remains as it is hot. And once again, for our viewers, the watchers for Go TV Channel 98, the watchers for Star Times Channel 195, the watchers for DSTV Channel 259, Free to Air Channel 57, or probably if we are, they do my TV Channel 17. At least before we go that break, we'll tell them we'll get two strong people. At least some special guests will go join us. And these special guests, as I talk, they'll be the PMB and PYO support group. That is the President Muhammadu Buhari and the Professor Yemi Osinbajo's support group. And them that they will toss and to come tell us, okay, waiting with that majority, we do it, and we they give them that ginger to talk, say, look, they will actually put out their own support for the president and the vice president to come back for the 2019. The person they're very close to me now, Adedeji Adepoju. And I'm the spokesperson for the group. Adeji, you are welcome to ask it a hot.
Thank you.
And the person we sit down right in front of me now, Temitope Ajay. Temitope, you're also welcome to ask it a hot.
Thank you very much.
Look, I want to make just day very free because in a conversation with the guy. Because I go ask questions.
I don't know how to
keep quiet. So I go ask questions, and as they ask the questions, at least I would expect me now at least make the tell our viewers, okay, now like this debut, see why this is this, see why that is that. But before we go quickly go into all this and the major reason why not coming, I go on make at least, I don't know if now be they listen to the headlines or the gist what they give before we go that break. Yes. Okay, first thing first, the National Assembly, they don't come and talk, say, look, the workers there come and talk, say, look, say, then they go on, they don't go on strike based on the fact, say, look, their salaries are not being paid. And we also know about, say, this matter, not be something just start today. Some couple of weeks back, at least we'll be here, the gist, say, look, did they complain, say, their salaries are being held. If we get at least an integral, like the legislative arm of government, we say, people where they work for them, they come and they complain. What be that? Which kind of level of integrity or sincerity in the tried state on the side of people who don't give that responsibility to lead us?
You know, see, what I would say, it gets so many matter we don't day on ground where this government inherits.
Okay.
No be matter we say start with them. So you know, what most people they do be say they try push all the blame on this administration. But before this administration, this matter don't day on ground before even this government enter. So no be matter we be say we go talk say na Buhari or Osinbajo administration cosa.
Okay.
Na matter we don't day before even this admission comes. So waiting this admission they do. Now we say all this matter we do on ground, they don't say they don't inherit them, but now to create or provide solution for this kind of matter we do on. So we don't talk say na this administration, because even the matter of lies, the matter of corruption, now something we don't day even as they create Nigeria.
Yeah, yeah.
So now you cannot, you know, if you blame one government for the problem we don't deal with, other people inherit. And also, as they enter this government, they don't complain about so many things where they leave behind. And this past administration get enough money at their coffers at the time they were in power. There was Ecuador was at a rate where they can't even pay all the salaries. But they know there was so many mismanagement of funds. But this administration, they have treated issues on pension, on issues of salary payment, but the matter they overwhelming.
It will take time. You know, it's easy to crumble building, but to build them back, they take time. So why this administration?
Okay, make I ask you, Ajay, Matabaji. You talk say a lot of things are spoiled in the past, but of course, we also a lot of us there will say the way political activity they play out here. At least people know they're too loyal to their own political party. We don't see several swaps. See this person.
Yes.
Like majorities of people with this same ruling party are were integral members.
Party.
You go talk, say, based on that, say now still say not be the same them.
The truth
even
say,
while if, the same people be same with ruling.
If system. Idea day, if ideology day, no how, bad eggs. You go find bad eggs in the midst of good ones. So the mission and the ideology be say we want change the narrative.
Okay.
But if something spoil, if something bad, then you go know who they lawyer and who know they lawyer. So the people where they hop from one party to another, it don't they obvious their ambition. Now pepper way sweet. I bet they talk that thing for now place way sweet. Then be one shook head, make them shine. Meaning say their interests. No, but to make things better. Now we are better day. They want you. So if you day, if you believe in a cause, you go stand firm no matter what you happen. Say this thing, no, whether through thick, whether through thin, I go day.
And that's talking about that's where we stand. We believe for this government.
Okay.
Because people say this government don't do better things. Okay. Where we stand to project, make people know what they don't do.
Okay. Yeah. In standing firm, where you also mentioned, you said at least the people who go believe say in trying to redefine that we need to stand firm. We could also probably make we bring them to the issue of this yearly fuel scarcity issues where they normally happen. Because we will feel recount the number of years, especially if you don't enter festive period. We always get these cases of fuel scarcity where they affect a lot of activities. Okay, the Senate the Senate committee with the charge of program don't come and talk to look, say some kind of bad belly people.
Exactly.
They do it and they try to make sure say they want to sabotage the system so that fuel goes scarce. Okay, if we don't get a system where at least this doesn't happen too often, what do you also expect make the government in place do so at least they go fit and feel rigid the system and ensure say there is a total end to this not yearly activity, though we never had the experiment, but the rumor don't go around. But how can the government also ensure, say, they put their feet on ground to make sure, say, look, we no see that case.
Okay.
The thing we say, no matter how much you create system, we better. If normal being dead there, fault must be. Because there's no perfection in the human system. Except we won't miss in our computer going to supply for it. And I don't know if it is possible. But no, this we say, in every government, where they, where they try to do better, some people don't sit down and say they're not going to make
that
better show.
Straight effort.
So the government always make adequate provision for supply and the distribution of fuel. But some people now, because of Babylon, you talk now, they go hold on. Is that to increase the price?
Yes.
Or to make sure say people suffer? Some people enjoy to see people suffer at the detriment of them making money.
Making money.
That's one of the problems where we get for this country. And this Buhari Oshibajo government, they are doing their best. And fighting corruption at the highest level. The way where Nigeria be for the past admission for international community, not be the way it be.
Not be the way it be.
They don't get respect for us. Pass as we did get respect. So many statements where people make about the past admission is not be the same statement they make now. So in a system where you say now people they involved, you cannot rule out sabotage.
Yes.
But what the government can do is to make sure that they block all the loopholes where they make this thing happen. So now waiting be the solution. And I know that his first season will be a lot more better because this government is working tirelessly to make sure that life become easy for Nigerians. We might not see the good work now,
immediately.
But when this administration go, we go praise them for what they don't do for us.
And 4 years, no day enough.
To
no reach to do what 16 years administration don't do. To correct the errors and the mistakes.
In fact, you need more than 16 years.
Okay.
You no reach.
I know so we will further go into at least all this activity. But make I also at least bring the issue of INEC and ask them the biggest them over opposition party don't come and talk, say, look, say, then they point hand, give INEC, say, INEC, people are say, hey, if they do wuru-wuru for this system ahead of the 2019 election, people are say, if they try, limp body with the ruling party. But then, a lot of questions also come and say, at least, say, INEC as it is, say, you know, they're properly independent, and which, of course, I won't believe, say, you go agree with me on that.
Yes.
You know, they're properly independent, and the facts say, you know, they're independent. How can a government, at least we also believe in integrity, ensure, say, integrity circulates around, rather than, you understand, just,
leaning on
You know, what the government will say, you have to be careful of the kind of information that fly around. Now, is that when you are saying that it's not independent, what is the objective of the people that are saying that? Now, some people don't get the impression, say, the ruling party, which is APC, won rig election with INEC. So far, so good in this country. The last election has proven that INEC is an independent body because they did justice. Even this is the first time in history where a sitting president will lose election, even in Africa, and we call to congratulate the incoming president, which is president-elect. It is because they saw that there was fairness and openness in the election. And I want to assure people that the Buhari Oshibajo administration is also making sure that this same thing happens again. Well, things are not going to lose, but there's not going to be any wuru-wuru. INEC is independent. They're going to work and make sure that everything works smoothly without any form of corruption because this government stands for zero tolerance for corruption. And I can assure you that INEC is not biased and they're going to do their job as they did in 2015 that brought in this good administration.
Okay. Quickly, make we at least take a step further and then at least I know Nigerians go there interested in knowing. So okay, this people will be PYO, this is support group. Say okay, waiting with that major thing or that thing where they different, where they won't tell us where at least we will never hear before. Okay. Quickly make we enter into the reason why you not come here.
Okay.
At least now don't carry that placard, say look. Say now, the continuation of PNB and at least PYO, Naina stand for.
Yes.
Okay. Make a first bring her from this angle. As young people, as you two wanna be. And I'm considering the fact, say, look, looking at the population, the talk say at least youth, now them, at least youth get a larger population going by
7 million.
And also looking at least the activities of youth over time and how the government don't also fail the youth. You understand? Waiting be that thing, because the same government still continues, government now continue at it. Waiting be that thing, we don't give now that lever to talk, say, okay, now this particular, as you two, and now this particular government will believe we will give us that credible or that future Nigeria.
Okay, the truth be say, everything where people they do now for the future. If person may give site instance, if person they cook food, no be now food they done. So we as youths, we believe say, as things be like say rough, as pitfalls day here and there for Niger, we believe say the future they bright.
Okay.
We, our job now as PYO PMB, that's Bwari Oshibanjo Southwest Group, we won't project the achievements of this administration.
Okay.
So even if results never, because people they always complain, say no money day, no money day pocket. But before people start to see results, something they cook for underground. So we believe say this administration in the next 4 years where they go take enter when they enter office, it sure say
results
go to show, because they don't do a lot for the media, for instance. This administration, they don't do a lot of things to make the creative industry more appealing. They don't then reduce tax for the creative industry. And you go agree with me, say, for creative industry, now youth food there.
Okay.
Now youth food there.
Okay.
Then
create jobs.
Yeah, create jobs. And then you look at the ICT as regards tech. They don't, in six geopolitical zones now, we have six tech hubs. In six different geopolitical zones. Mm. So these are the things that we have seen, and we know that the government then gets interest of the youth.
I know, say, this age now is an information technology age.
Yes, yes.
And the government, the vice president do a tech of tour.
Yes.
He go different technology hubs to support. See, one thing I want to encourage you is that the youth must follow the trend that is happening right now, and key yourself to the agenda of the administration. More than ever before, more than any administration, this administration has been about improving technology and the lives of you, creating jobs. Now, entertainment industry alone has employed a lot of people. I can tell you, a lot of youth now, from media to TV, everything has created a lot of jobs. And this government has given support as much as fighting the end of piracy and all those issues have been on ground. But you know, waiting.
Make I at least cut you halfway. Okay. If we look at you, of course, now talk say creation of more jobs and all that. See this administration in the cost of ensuring say say they don't create more jobs. But on the other hand, a lot of people don't agree with you now.
Okay.
Of course.
Yeah, of course.
If we also can look at statistically, at least from the Bureau of Statistics, the statistics they bring out about the number of job loss under this government, where they run into millions. Okay, Sheikh also fit talk say, looking at the job loss we don't get, and also looking at emphasis on say, okay, more jobs are still lost. Sheikh, it is say, what did this government don't create so far, don't feel much of it, waiting don't lose under them.
Okay, you know what I'm gonna be say? When you talk say job loss, you know, opposition, when they look for better thing to talk about the opposition.
And that, opposition,
so now, that all job loss is that, I want to assure you that there'll be more job creation than job loss. But it's what we're looking at that we'll focus on. So now, if people are focusing on the job loss, what of the job creations? Do you know that Empower as a scheme has created job and empowered entrepreneurs that people are not focusing on? Nobody talks about Empower.
Nobody talks about it.
But people are talking about job loss. Now, this administration, more than ever before, has encouraged entrepreneurship.
Yes.
They funded it. They've made funds available for people who are ready to learn skills, people who are ready to learn trades. You know, even more than ever before, I think this government has the best trade negotiation scheme ever for foreign direct investment, for us to have people come in and invest, investors to come into the country. But you know, the problem is that when you don't look or see the opportunity, it doesn't mean that they don't exist.
They don't exist.
The opportunities are there, but we need to That's what we have. Mm. We are trying to let people know that these are the opportunities. Let us project these opportunities.
Key into it. Be aware.
Key into it. Some people don't know. Most youth are not informed about the things that are happening around them.
But if you are saying key into opportunities, the existing opportunities, at least first when they're hungry, no go on listen to all these ones really talk.
Yes.
And if you also come look at Oga Presido, don't come out several talks. He understands the plight of Nigeria. Yeah. Just recently, Oga Presido come out talk say, look, they make the demand for more time from Nigeria. Say, look, give me more time. You understand? We can also recall with Nigeria talk one time. Mm-hmm. Say, he come out talk say, look, I know you people are suffering. Okay, these are coming from the number one citizen of the country. Okay, and if you continuously they give out this thing and then you know can't balance with waiting the people they feel. Mm. Say how much of patience you go expect make Nigerians get for us to be able to achieve this particular goal?
Patience hard. Patience no be something where they talk from mouth. As we did, so we suppose get enduring the spirit of endurance. Not be say maybe just they wait, maybe no they see. Mm-hmm. Realistic things, but if two elephants they fight, now the grass they suffer, no doubt. So as much as we understand, say people they suffer, money no day pocket, and the president don't assure the his citizens, say now so now like this things be. I believe we should also make an enabling environment for ourselves.
For to work.
So as much as you're waiting for the government, do something, work.
Great
job. The government is working, yes, but as much as you're waiting, and if you think personally, say you know see results, people know they give you chance. You take chances.
Okay, how much of chances you feel say Nigerians feel take, considering the kind of country we would be, and considering the fact say that enabling environment not also day for people to fit grab them or use the opportunity.
One thing I go talk, we say there are two sides to a coin.
Okay, yes.
And some people they complain, say opportunity will day. You will hear some success story, you go shocked and see the same country they happen. I don't understand how they talk. It's a two-way thing, but one thing is that we are focusing too much on what is not working, but a lot of things are working. So many things they work where we don't focus on. Is that the same opportunities and people are not there. Some people they complain, say no day. Mm-hmm. Some people take the opportunity and they make them.
Utilize those opportunities.
So the thing now is that the young people need to get out of this mentality of laying back and what it is to happen. They need to be involved in policy. As we did as a group now, we not wait, say, make the country give us money before we come and consult, say we support better thing.
Okay.
We see the work. We don't interview people, we don't go meet people for where them day. People don't collect Empower money. They don't start business with this money.
The
Empower scheme, when they do to release funds for entrepreneur, we have met people, we have interviewed people who are doing very well.
So part of which is the trade money, this thing?
No, trade money is different. But this Empower scheme now for young entrepreneurs that need access to funds. Okay. So many people don't know about this. They don't even know how to apply. Money has been made available for agriculture. Young farmers that want to farm. Bank of Agriculture has funds available. But I can tell you that those banks are complaining that people are not accessing the funds.
Even if some youth go, they say, me, farm. I will do dirty job.
Farm now for old people.
And then I'm saying, dirty job now, where money day.
Okay,
you know?
You talk about, before we go for this break, I would not drop this question. So by the time we come back, you talk about assessing of funds. Say some people know go do this.
Some people don't go to assess this.
Don't you also think, as a government in place,
you
at least, you're also expected to monitor what they do. At least they monitor how your money they take worker, and also monitor at least where your money they go, whether the result they properly come out or not.
Yes.
But now when we come back from this break, at least I will expect now to answer that one. So we'll go for this break when they come. Yes, and welcome back. The program remains as it is hot, and at least I know say our viewers don't they do it. Now they're ready to say they won't call in to ask questions. And very soon we'll open our phone line. So at may they also feel calling and them at least ask one or two questions. And then for studio, at least we'll get them Adedeji Adepoju will be the spokesperson of the PNB PYO support group. We can also get them Temitope Ajay, we also follow and come. We'll be all of them they the same group. And then before we go for that break, I'll be asked one particular question. We'll get to do with them at least how does government they monitor in activities, especially when they release funds? So at them at least they go sure, so okay, this fund is going into the right places, because over time we don't hear say funds are being released for this, we are advancing in this, development is taking place in this. But some people also come and talk, say, look, we know they see the result of this development. How the government they monitor their own funding? So at them at least make me say that's what they talk about, people they see them.
Say the government gets system of how they work.
Okay.
When it gets money, they take come out. Mm-hmm. It gets as money they come out, and the National Assembly, there are committees for different of these that do oversight functions to follow up on all these things. You know, now, wait till I want to say, you know, I will try to maybe subsequently share a report, a midterm report of this administration to people to go and read, or if it's even available online.
Yeah.
You'll be shocked at the amount of things that have been done that people don't know about. So the truth is that when you don't find information or when you don't have adequate fact about something, it doesn't give you the reason to believe that nothing is being done. You know, these informations are readily available of the achievements and the follow-up and the results that they've gotten. And you can counter-check it. If it's false, then you can say it's wrong. So this information, when I read the midterm report that the administration did, that was even 2017. They've not even done one for 2018. I was really shocked about the things that have been done in this space of years. But you know, Nigeria is a country whereby if we don't see them now, it means they know they
nothing
work.
Nothing is happening.
But you know me say, because the thing is that now when this administration finished their 8 years ago, people go there and say, this country don't get respect. Now, if you carry green passport anywhere now, the respect different from when about 16 years ago. Because now, one thing that has been the major problem, which is the major bunker problem, now this corruption. And the third person, one day say, people that also be corruption, focus on the economic development and all that. If you focus on economic development, if you have corrupt people in the economy, they will run it down.
I bet we'll get to our first caller. Basi, good evening, welcome to us in the hut.
Good evening.
Yes, we didn't hear you talk to us, Basi.
All right, my own contribution, you know, all these things that you are, you know, these people they are sitting down, they talk, we just hear them because, one, we are not a fool, we are not a kid. We know everything that is happening. We see on our eyes without being told. So everybody has their own decision to take when election time reach.
Okay.
For them to be telling us, fighting, you, how can you fight for corruption? Then people are dying. You are fighting for corruption. We see face hardship. Your son. So all the things I believe the Bible says, Egyptians that we see today, we shall see them no more. I believe everything that has beginning must surely get end. So thank you. That's my contribution.
Okay, thank you very much, Embassy, for that solid contribution. I don't know. Blase will get under person with our telephone line. Okay. So you
respond to Basi talk now. They don't say people they die. Maybe soldiers. Maybe they. Do you know? Say corruption is really why soldiers don't have equipment to fight the war.
Okay.
Let's look at it from that angle.
Okay.
Money was released in the past administration, $2.1 billion, to buy ammunition for the Nigerian military. Okay. Till today, the case is still in court because people squandered the money.
Okay.
See, corruption is tied to everything. Okay. So when you don't kill the virus called corruption, even though it leads $200 billion to the economy, it no go show. So when we're talking about corruption, that people are dying, people are hungry. Now, one person sit down on top of the money now. We don't make our flow.
Okay, talking about corruption, make a relate them. A lot of people don't come out talk say local. Like for instance, PDP, for instance, don't come out allege say make President Muhammad Buhari come out, can't do anything, can't give account of the 11 trillion naira where they missing for the oil sector under in present government, which of course I will refer them as alleged. And then also we don't also hear reports say, look, say the government in place, no, they question people where they own this way, they corrupt, they don't allow, say, if they corrupt. But I just pause on that and I will ask the question, but we'll get another person with their telephone line. Adebisi, good evening.
Good evening, my brother.
Yeah, we greet you.
How are things
now? Good day, fine.
My brother, I want to contribute to this conversation.
Yeah, we hear you.
My point is this. You know, what this government have, what they are clamoring for now, what they are trying to do, has been fighting corruption and doing other stuff.
Okay.
It's not everybody that would like it. Whether we like it or not, 15 years of corrupted people, it's not a joke. You understand? It's not a joke. So you can expect that there are a lot of millionaires that is the previous government has produced. And all those people will not keep quiet. They will need to be fighting back. And because of that, whatever these people have been, I know it's real. So I will not be able to participate or to see much. But believing in this government, I know it's doing a lot of things.
Okay.
And people will not allow him to, they will be criticizing him, which is normal. So our own, as a young people and as a good citizen of Nigeria, is to focus and know what to do next year. And I know God will help us with this thing.
Amen.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
From our DBC, make we enter, join Ifeanyi. Ifeanyi, good evening. Welcome to us, the heart. Okay, blessed we don't lose him. Ifeanyi. Okay, at least the emphasis on now about corruption. Now, make I ask Aji. I don't know anybody with you, Sam. Okay, how you go take define the corruption fight so far? She go talk say so far the corruption fight under this leadership. They fair at being and still something where they in progress.
No, we say everything where they do now they in progress. Now why they want come 2019? But so far, a reasonable amount of returns have been gotten. Okay. So in this issue of corruption, no be one day fight where we go fight and go relax, say we don't achieve our goal. So it's even if then come out after their 4 years tenure, once they get reelected 2019, it's still a fight that continues. So it's not something that they do in 4 years and feel they have arrived. No, I don't think so. I think it's something that is continuous, and even the next administration that would outlive us should continue to fight, because trust me, corruption is not just secluded to politics alone. You'll find out that an average Nigerian is corrupt while just shouting, our leaders, our leaders, our leaders. People are not truthful. People are greedy out there. Okay. So it's not solely about our leaders. It's something that has eaten deep into the culture, and it has to be.
Okay. Fine. You talk about say you don't eat deep, which of course a lot of Nigerians could say yes to an extent. But as a leader, people where they at the helm of affair, maybe say at least corruption they also they play out. How we also expect at least government, especially when our president talks, look, fighting corruption now one of the key this thing. How the government in place go also at least beyond just waiting with the scene now, at least make they also fit and ensure say. This through the fight against corruption, they properly addressed and properly rejected, so at least those loopholes where people they take carry money, you know, we'll feed you thing. But I beg you, going to pause. We'll get somebody there at the telephone line. Hello, good evening.
Good evening.
Yes, talk to us, we hear you.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
I want to give all down my two brothers as you idea.
Okay, would they hear your God divine?
See, the issue of corruption fight. I really don't believe in corruption fight in this administration.
Why you talk so?
They know they fight any corruption.
Why you talk so, God divine?
And why I talk so, you say, the money when we hear for Ikoyi House, Mr. President never tell us, say, now this amount, now this person, now get this money. So that Nigerians will know the day who they see their money. And again, you get the time where our president can tell us the Indonesian, the names of the people where they steal our money. And up to date, Mr. President never come out and can tell us, say, now this one or that one, I they steal our money. That one is the second one. Okay. The third one, we say, our president don't talk, say, he will better our life in 3 years up to now. Our president, you know, they continue to complain about the PDP government. If they complain about the PDP government, why we vote out the PDP government out? Now, because we believe that Mr. President Nine will try.
Yes.
On this meeting with the new four. But since that time, Mr. President, people are giving us excuses. And we are then in hunger and poverty. And our president continue enjoying eating a good food and his family, and leaving the Nigerians to suffer and continue to give us false food. So we are no longer interested in whatever Mr. President is doing. I want to tell him fully, I'm a Nigerian, and I believe in one Nigerian, and I believe everyone belongs to this nation. And I want Mr. President out in 2019. That is my
okay, Oga Divine, thank you very much. From Sule, Yameku, come back to Lagos. Collect this call. Good evening, and welcome to Ask the Heart. Oga Festus.
Hey, good evening, my brother. How are you?
Yeah, we'll greet you.
How you doing? I greet everybody there.
Yeah,
how
you they hear you?
We thank God.
Okay.
I just put some mouth for this matter when they talk.
Okay, fire on, they hear you.
Okay. You know, my brother, everything sometimes, as that my sister talk. Everybody was looking at top.
I beg, Oga Festus, if you get the opportunity, try call us back, I beg. Yes. And our phone line is still very much open for any viewer. We won't call in to call in. Okay, Divine, they complain about that same thing. The question where they ask about corruption. Say, money, where they recover and all that. With Alpha. Okay, and then also they talk, say, the government also they will fight corruption, but they never really they see the effect. So how then, beyond just waiting with the scene now, how can the government further proceed in this particular fight. So at least, in all sincerity, go Nigeria go fit and say yes. Will they see an effective result without they change our own lives as a citizens?
Mm. You see, I once cite one example of my friend where they work for, we get job for federal government paraceta.
Okay.
You know, I see the process which she go through to get, I've been on probation to get a letter to confirm that she is a true worker, not a ghost worker.
Mm.
That process will screen out anybody who is a ghost worker.
Okay.
You go through different procedures. In the past, that's another area of corruption.
Mm-hmm.
People who are dead on the payrolls, some people in pension and all those areas. Yeah. See, this corruption fight is wide. People are only narrowing it down to only politicians. No, civil servants. Mm. You will see a palm cell of a ministry that is richer than a minister. The corruption going on in civil services, which this government have been trying to curb and cut as well.
I beg, I got to just stay pause. You go continue from where you stop. We got Joshua, good evening.
Good evening, Oga Nkubi.
We greet you, Oga Joshua.
How is it now?
We dey fine.
Greet us now.
We dey hear you talk to us.
Okay. According to the matter, you think when me have to talk with me, see this present government, they don't really try. I know they support them.
Okay.
But more talk the truth. 16 years. 16 years. Look at it now, just barely 3 years. I know so many things we don't happen. Although people don't really want to know about the one we don't do. Okay. Now those things we never do, neither they leak.
Mm.
Okay, we'll tell ourselves the truth now.
Okay. Okay.
At least workers are receiving, even if they are not receiving so much salary, at least they are receiving something.
Okay.
So, let's just give them a try.
Okay.
I believe by next 4 years, because I'm very, very determined that Buhari will come again, whether they like it or not. So
thank you for believing in.
Okay, Oga Joshua, thank you very much for that contribution. Yeah. And continue to.
So no, all those there are different areas: civil servants, the areas of pension. So many areas of pensions have been cleared in this administration. Or people who have been owed pension, the process of getting your pension, the areas of ghost workers in federal civil service, you know, so many areas. Like, I know one thing is that we need to find facts before we talk. You see, if we don't have facts as a group of young people, we will not come out and say we want to support this government. Because we saw, we went to search for things. We realized that so all this amount of things has been done.
Okay.
And that means that we need to come as young people and mobilize other young people as well to believe in this country.
Okay.
To believe that the Nigeria is under a process going to a place of transformation. And that's why the next level campaign for getting them into office again is really taking Nigeria to the next level.
Okay.
So we need to believe that this country is on a path to greatness. Okay. It might be tough now, it might be rough, but we need to endure. Mm. Because 16 years of hardship to 4 years of correction is not enough. We need more than 16 years to correct the damages.
Okay, make we take them further, and at least we're also without looking to economy slightly, looking to corruption. Make we take them further, because I try to focus on those major things we have got present. We will look security matter.
Okay.
Okay. Just recently, Amnesty International come out release reports say, look, so over 3,600 people from 2016 die for herdsmen and farmer clashes. And as we speak, we still see at least issues. I mean, Boko Haram, to an extent, see the at least pockets of issues where they happen for this thing. We still get these same reports from all these northeastern regions.
Yes.
Looking at this particular thing, waiting the government on their own part don't also do, because if we look what happened recently about those soldiers we die. A lot of people talk say, look, but not talking about the fight, not the ensure saying our protectors. But how come we still lose soldiers? Okay, waiting be that thing where they miss, where we say the government in place never really fit look into. In as much as we don't say to an extent they don't touch, do not try, but to ensure say that security at least ensure say it go around the way Nigerians really want see them at least. What do you think about that part?
You know, the issue of security, in all fairness, we're going to be sincere ourselves. I like the way we said there are pockets of issues, not issues. Past administrations, there was no day, there was no bumping in this country. Bumping from different places to different places. Even Boko Haram took territories. They were in local governments and raising their flags.
But make a cut on that. Okay, Boko Haram at least release statement and say they don't take over territory. But there is also another report where the emir of Borno, come out and talk, say, look, say Boko Haram still they dominate, they disturb like
I can tell you now that there is no local government under the control of Boko Haram in Nigeria. Every territory is a bit, the way these people operate now is a guerrilla warfare. How do what's a guerrilla warfare is that they come, they strike, and they go. They don't have a base anymore. Okay. Where they say that they can say that they control a community. There's no community in Nigeria that Boko Haram still controls. The only thing they do is that they just come, strike, and they move. So right now, they don't have a base anymore. So now you don't know who is who now. So that means that the fight is being won. Every day, there's always a meeting going on, security meetings going on about. The truth is that we are going to be saying ourselves, the issue of Boko Haram in the past administration is not the same as now. There's been great improvement. Like I said, just recently, some helicopters were purchased. Gun helicopters were purchased for the Nigerian Air Force to make sure that they combat this issue, area support, area strikes, and all that. To be sincere, security matter has greatly improved. Okay. It might not be what we want it to be. It cannot vanish all of a sudden, but there has been great improvement.
Okay.
Because as far as I'm concerned, it is an embarrassment for a terrorist group to be raising their flag on the soil of a country, but it's not happening. It happened in the past administration, but right now, the flags are flying in all those communities, are Nigerian flags, and Nigerian militaries have taken over all those territories. The only thing that we need to curb now is the loopholes of them coming in and striking and going, which is what happened to those soldiers. And, those things have been worked on, but I can say that there has been great improvement on security matter.
I know we'll get time again, and at least we'll only wrap up. If on a final note, waiting at least if not, which information is Nafisa na get for Nigerians? I know Nigeria go talk, waiting this pool, besides just waiting again with that information we not get for Nigerians. May not put them out, may they hear now.
Okay.
All right, we want bring it out there to all Nigerians, say may ona believe in this administration, first things first, and may ona try to be aware. Now part of our job. To put out there their achievements, what they don't achieve for the past 3.5 years, and what they are willing to. So may on a day aware, may on a believe, say, things fit still happen. And the number to call, because we be support group. So if on a get any questions, if na information way on a one get, the number be 0807-530-7206. May I call them again? 0807-530-7206. For our social media handles too, now BOSW Group. Be on all social media platforms, either na Facebook or Instagram or Twitter. Now BOSW Group for all social media platforms.
Well, thank you very much, Timi Tokpe, Aji, and Adedeji, Adepoju. I want to really thank them for coming. And at least the same way we talk, the same way we get the support group, and so every other person get their support group. So we they open to anybody coming in. At least now, I want to just ask questions. The way we supposed to ask them. So tomorrow we will come again with another beautiful edition of our program, As It Hot. From me, Ewebi Nkubi. Now, bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
To enjoy more of these our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.